dLife first met Brandon Morrow in 2009. A highly touted first-round draft choice, struggling to find his place with the Seattle Mariners, even spending some time in the minor leagues that season. There was even some lingering whispers that his battle with diabetes may have been affecting his ability to pitch in the major leagues. A short 2 years later, having since been traded to the Toronto Blue Jays, Morrow has gone from prospect to the club's number two pitcher.
You know, I think it's a blessing that I was traded over to Toronto and for them to give me the opportunity to be in the rotation full time.
In his inaugural season with the Jays, he turned in arguably one of the year's best performances, missing out on a no-hitter with two outs in the ninth and striking out 17 along the way.
17 strikeouts, one hit, first career complete game.
I think it's a great feat on its own, you know, besides the fact that I'm diabetic. You know, in my baseball career, I try to downplay that fact, and, you know, hopefully people would focus on me as a player and say, you know, that was a great game for a baseball player, not just a great game for a diabetic.
Morrow was in his groove that day, and he pitched the game of his life. But it started out like every other day.
I carry the same routine through every day that I start, starting with when I wake up. I sleep in, of course, and then I wake up and I have, you know, something with a lot of carbs and some protein in it. And then I get to the field and relax for a while. And then I have my Myoplex protein bar, give myself some energy for the game. And those things and that routine just really help to keep my sugars in, you know, the zone that I want them to, which happens to be, you know, a little bit high in maybe the 120 to 140 range, but, you know, you want to make sure that you're not going to fall in low during the game. If ever I have a problem, it's in my pregame bullpen, where if I maybe tried to get my sugars a little perfect, then I might drop just slightly low.
Just like every pro athlete, maintaining his health is a top priority. His just happens to include diabetes.
The fact that I have, you know, such a set routine that I follow, that really takes the pressure off myself in a medical or health aspect. You know, most of the people around here have seen it before and they're familiar with the routine. You know, if I have a good game or something, they'll make a joke like, hey, the blood sugar was really good today, or, you know, something like that.
Morrow's former teammate and close friend Mark Lowe, who was diagnosed with type 1 in 2008, was traded before the 2010 season to the Texas Rangers. Despite the change in geography, the two keep in touch via texting and talking on the phone as often as possible.
Mark's he's quite a character and got a great personality. But when he was diagnosed, it was, you know, it brought us pretty tight together and, you know, we shared that bond and helped each other out.
Brandon is also reaching out to children. Last year, he hosted a camp with minor league player Travis Snyder to educate young athletes with diabetes.
You know, I'd call them all up and then ask them, all right, how many of you are diabetic? And they'd all raise their hand, and then I'd raise my hand as well, you know, and I think they were all surprised that I was diabetic, and then we'd get out our insulin pumps, and I'd show them mine, and they'd get all excited, like, yeah, I got the same one. And it was pretty cool.